Hey everyone, for those just tuning in, I'm Benji Yang, Product Manager at Shopify. In this video, I'll be walking you through how to group your keywords or how to structure your accounts. Before we get started, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel to get the latest insights on building with Shopify. In talking about account structure, there's a simple, there's a good, and there's sort of a better structure that most advertisers for search ads tend to gravitate towards. The whole concept behind how to group your ad keywords and how to structure your ads is you want to optimize your account to ensure that the ads or the campaigns with the highest return or like the best performance on a cost per install basis are getting the appropriate level of budget. And how this kind of manifests, so think of your account as having a finite budget, which most advertisers do. You have a finite budget of $30 a day, and you want to make sure that it's spent most optimally. The simplest way to structure your account is just to have one ad or one campaign for everything. So all of your broad match keywords, all your exact match keywords, just throw it into one ad and have a single budget of, let's say, $30 a day for this ad and just sort of let it run. The pros for this is it's very simple, and on an aggregate account level, it's probably relatively low maintenance. But the cons for this is that you don't really have a lot of control over, or you don't have as much control over which keyword is allocated how much budget. In any campaign, there's going to be keywords that vastly outperform other ones, but this isn't necessarily going to be reflected in the spend amounts. And so this is a major con for just having the simple structure of everything in one, is that all of your keywords will share that budget according to the opportunity to acquire clicks or to generate traffic to your app listing page, and not necessarily in the order that optimizes your keywords for best results. That brings us to a better or sort of good structure, which is instead of having everything all in one place, you'll wanna break out your exact and your broad match keywords. And the idea behind this is that exact match keywords typically are more focused. They typically offer you more clear results as far as cost per install and install volume, as you're only bidding on very specific search terms or keywords. And often is the case that some keywords generate the vast majority of your returns. So if you're bidding on 10 keywords, there probably is two or three that are generating the most installs at the lowest cost per install. And so it stands to reason that you want to pull these out and you want to allocate budget dedicated to these. And the other reason you want to separate exact match from broad match keywords is that in broad match campaigns, you'll tend to match to so many things outside of the actual keyword itself, which is great for other things. But as far as performance and focus is concerned, that's not sort of the strength of broad match keywords. That really is the strength of exact match keywords. And so you'll want to have these separate, where you have a dedicated budget for your exact match keywords and a dedicated ad for your broad match keywords. And the one level up from this is something that I've already sort of started with this example right here, but to separate not only by exact and broad match keywords, but also separate by theme. So staying with the Shopify example, one theme could be e-commerce keywords, exact match. Another theme could be, well, this is the same theme actually, e-commerce keywords for broad match. Another theme could be shipping exact match keywords. And if I wanted to go, I probably would actually, but I'd create a shipping broad match keyword campaign. And what this does is it gives you even more clear delineation of which keywords, like which themes are producing good results with which match type. Just to sort of recap here, you generally want to separate out at least your exact match from your broad match keywords, just so you can focus your budget on performing keywords for exact match campaigns. And a more optimal way to structure these usually is to separate these by exact, broad, and by theme, so that you know which theme is producing what type of result. Thanks for tuning in to how to group your keywords or how to structure your accounts. I hope you found this video helpful. If you'd like to learn more about how to manage your bids and optimizations, tune in to my next video in this playlist. And of course, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel to get the latest updates on our products and tools.